Hello friends, welcome again. In this video, we display most important questions for staff nurse preparation. These questions will help you for your upcoming all type of staff nurse or nursing officer preparation. This is test number 23. Previously 22 tests also available and more videos on nursing officer or staff nurse preparation available on this channel. Please see them also. Let's start staff nurse preparation test number 23, most important questions and answer. Question number 1. Which of the following is hereditary hemolytic anemia? Option A, aplastic anemia. Option B, pernicious anemia. Option C, thalassemia. And option D, megaloblastic anemia. Answer is option C, thalassemia. Thalassemia, also known as Coolidge anemia or Mediterranean anemia. Thalassemia is a hereditary anemia occurring due to defective production of the alpha or beta chain of hemoglobin. Next, question number 2. The normal mean pulmonary artery pressure is option A, 15 to 20 mmHg. Option B, 20 to 25 mmHg. Option C, 40 to 65 mmHg, and option D, 10 to 15 mmHg. The correct answer is option B, 20 to 25 mmHg is the normal mean pulmonary artery pressure. How to calculate normal pulmonary artery pressure? See the formula. Mean pulmonary artery pressure is equal to diastolic pressure is twice plus systolic pressure and all is divided by 3. Let's see answer friends. Here 2 by 20 plus 30 divided by 3. So 70 by 3 is equal to 23 mmHg is the mean pulmonary artery pressure. Because the normal pulmonary artery pressure is 30 by 20 mmHg. So friends, correct answer is option B, 20 to 25 mmHg. Next, question number 3. Typical age for onset of anorexia nervosa. Option A, 10 to 12 years. Option B, 8 to 10 years. Option C, 14 to 16 years. And option D, 28 and above years. The age for typical onset of anorexia nervosa. Next, answer is average age for onset of anorexia nervosa is 17 years and range is 13 to 19 years. So correct answer is option C, 14 to 16 years is typical age for onset of anorexia nervosa. Bulimia nervosa occurs between age 18 to 59 years with onset at 20 years. Next, question number 4. Increased level of ketone bodies into diabetic ketoacidosis occurs due to wrong oxidation of option A, fat, option B, carbohydrate, and option C, protein, and option D is minerals. Answer is option A, fat. Due to lack of insulin, glucose not enter to the cell. In absence of glucose, the cell utilizes the fat and metabolizes it. After metabolism, the end product of fat is ketone, which is acid. Due to excessive fat metabolism, the ketone bodies build up at a high level and cause diabetic ketoacidosis. Next, question number 5. CSSD is used for storage of option A, dirty bedpans, option B, soiled linen, option C, sterile supply, and option D, waste. The correct answer is option C, sterile supply. CSSD stands for Central Sterile Supply Department. This department stores the sterile material for hospital use. Next, question number 6. Psychosexual disorder in which sexual behavior is directed to animals. Option A, fetishism. Option B, proteurism. Option C, bestiality. And option D, transvestism. Correct answer is option C, transvestism. Other option also, see friends, the fetishism is a problem in which a person has sexual urges associated with non-living objects. In fetishism, non-living objects, the person urges sexual. Next, frotteurism. Frotteurism, people who have this disorder are sexually aroused by touching and rubbing their body against a non-consenting person. Without other person's consent, the persons with frotteurism is aroused by touching and rubbing their body. The behavior usually occurs in crowded places. Next is transvestism. Transvestism is this, in this person gets sexual arousal by wearing opposite sex dresses. Next, question number 7. What should be the temperature of water used for cold sponging? Option A, 98 degree Fahrenheit. Option B, 105 degree Fahrenheit. And option C, 0 degree Fahrenheit. And option D, 70 degree Fahrenheit. Correct answer is option D, 70 degree Fahrenheit. For cold sponging, water temperature should be between 65 to 90 degree Fahrenheit. Next, question number 8. Unwanted thought with repetitive ritual behavior refers to option A, stress, option B, anxiety, option C, OCD, and option D, phobia. Correct answer is option C, OCD. OCD stands for obsessive compulsive disorder. This is a thought and psychomotor disturbance characterized by repetitive and unwanted thoughts, ideas, and feelings that result into repetitive ritualistic action. Next, question number 9. Elevated mood with increased psychomotor activity is characteristic feature of option A, mania, option B, euphoria, option C, depression, and option D, dysthymia. The correct answer is option A, mania. Elevated mood with increased psychomotor activity is seen in mania. Mania and depression both are bipolar disorder. In mania, elevated mood and activity is seen. In depression, characterized by low mood, a feeling of sadness, and a general loss of interest in things. Euphoria is a desirable and natural occurrence when it results from happy or exciting event. Dysthymia is persistent more than 2 years, mild depression. Next, question number 10. Colostomy tube for irrigation of bowel is inserted up to option A, 10 cm, option B, 9 to 17 cm, option C, 12 to 18 months, and option D, 20 to 30 cm. Correct answer is option A, 10 cm or 4 inch. Next, question number 11. Hot water application is contraindicated in option A, dysmenorrhea, option B, appendicitis, option C, muscular pain, and option D, hypothermia. Option D is hypothermia. So, correct answer is option B, appendicitis. To prevent bleeding, the hot application is prevented in appendicitis. Next, question number 12. The ratio of compression and ventilation in adult with 2 ratio is option A, 15 to 2 ratio, option B, 30 to 2 ratio, and option C, 1 ratio 5, option D, 20 ratio 10. The correct answer is option B, 30 ratio 2. In condition of adult, even 1 or 2 ratio present, the ratio is constant, which is 30 ratio 2. In condition of infant, if 1 ratio is present, then the ratio for compression and ventilation is 30 ratio 2. In condition of 2 ratio, the infant should be compressed at 15 ratio 2 ventilation. So here correct answer for in adult condition is 30 ratio 2. remain same for one or more rescuers. Next, question number 13. BID stands for option A, 3 times in a day, option B, 2 times in a day, option C, 4 times in a day, and option D, before dinner. It is straightforward questions, friends. You know its answer. Let's see answer, friends. The correct answer is option B, 2 times in a day. BD or BID means bis in die, means 2 times in 2 a day. Okay friends, thanks for watch full video. Please like, share and subscribe our channel. Thanks for watch full video.